In this video, I'm going to show you the incredible flexibility of the Tieline iMix G3 IP codec as a remote broadcast and communications tool. I'll show you how it replaces thousands of dollars worth of equipment. iMix combines six essential live broadcast products into one box, weighing just 4 pounds or 1.8 kilos. It can be used for talk shows, sports, music, field-to-studio communications and live events. iMix was designed by live sports radio and television event broadcasting specialists to integrate communications, control and programming functions while significantly reducing the setup time, number of people required on site, endless wiring and signal distribution costs. Let's start with the front panel. The mixer. There are five mic-line switchable inputs with configurable comms on each channel. Each channel has its own on-off button with fine input gain adjustment. The on-off button can be configured as a cough button, which is permanently on and then pressed to cough, and then we're back on air. Software gain can also be set up for line level, unbalanced, and three mic levels of 55 dB, 65 dB, and 72 dB, with fine gain adjustment on top of that. The next major feature is IFB and comms. This row of yellow buttons enables a powerful suite of communications. Let's say I had three commentators on inputs 1, 2 and 3, plus an effects microphone on input 4 and a producer on input 5. I can configure iMix so that when commentator 1 presses comms 1, it mutes input 1, splits the headphones for each person at this end of the link into program in the left ear and comms in the right ear, and everyone can hear him. I can also configure the producer's comms button to activate the cue matrix on the remote Tieline so that he can speak directly to the studio. All this happens without interrupting the program. Incidentally, we have found some customers like to have on-off buttons and comms buttons switched around so that on-off is here and comms is here. Also, the input and headphone control knob functionality can be switched. This is a simple software switch to make this happen. Now we have the send return mix. This allows any headphone to select between hearing only what's going to the studio or what's coming from the studio for foldback or a mix of both. The telephone coupler feature. iMix comes with two RJ11s on the back. One is a built-in POTS modem allowing 15 kHz bidirectional audio over a standard analog telephone line. The other one is a voice coupler, which allows voice calls to be made. Using the front panel telephone coupler, I can take live callers in the field. When the call comes in, it will flash on this button. I can pick up the call by pressing the button, which puts the caller into queue mode. Input 1 mic is muted for program, and announcer 1 can talk to the caller off-air. When we are ready to take the caller live, we just press the on button, and this brings the call into the mix. Special telephone ducking software ensures that the caller can never talk over the announcer, and it has a built-in mix minus, so the caller cannot hear themselves back over the line. Then we can put the caller back into queue mode to take details or talk off-air, and then hang up the call. PA output feature. The PA output gives me control over whether I send local audio or return audio from the studio out to the speakers, or a mixture of both. I have control over the PA with the on-off button. I can also send live callers to my output with my main program. Over here we have configurable hotkeys. This is where things get really powerful. Built into the iMix is the ability to configure profiles, trigger local relays, trigger remote relays over your codec link, switch comms channels, automatically dial specific locations with pre-saved profiles, and many more. These four hotkeys can be easily programmed to do any one of those things. Tieline can be configured for non-technical users. Before sending it into the field, the engineer can pre-program all parameters so that all the talent needs to know is how to plug in a microphone and the power. Then press one button to connect to the studio over any network and you're on the air. You can connect to an IP network and deliver 20 kHz mono, stereo or dual mono with low latency to another Tieline on the other side of the planet You can also plug into an ordinary analog telephone line, also known as POTS or PSTN line, and dial back to another Tieline, delivering up to 15 kHz bidirectional audio with less than 100 milliseconds delay. There is an additional module slot, which takes a wireless 3G card capable of two channels of 20 kHz stereo over wireless cell phone broadband networks. This card will also connect over GSM networks and make a wireless voice call. All you need to do is plug in your SIM card and choose your country and your network in the menu, and you're ready to dial. The module slot can also take an ISDN card, which will connect to any brand of ISDN codec, and we even have an X21 digital lease line card. Each card is sold separately. The Digital Matrix Router. Built into each iMix is a powerful digital audio matrix router, which enables you to route any audio input to any audio output. Let's say you wanted commentators on inputs 1 and 2 to go to codec encoder 1 only, and headphones 1 and 2. You can choose to put their audio on PPM 1 and the background noise microphone on PPM 2. You can then route their communications buttons to either side of their headphones or the other end of the codec link. A producer would not go to air, so input 5 will only go to encoder 2, which is for comms or taking live callers. You can also set up profiles for each broadcast. Simply load the profile to broadcast at different locations or studios. Now let's turn it around and look at the back. You can see we have the power cable here. It's a 4-pin XLR that snaps into place and cannot be knocked out. The iMix can also run on 12 volts, so you can hook up any 12 volt battery source or even a UPS and run the codec without wires. Here are the 5 micline balanced switchable inputs, then 2 balanced outputs. The RCAs are an additional unbalanced input. There are 4 headphone outputs. Now we get to another major feature of the iMix, remote control. Between the RS-232 port and these 2 sets of CMOS relay closures, you can trigger relays at each end of your codec link, or connect up a computer with control software and send control data via the RS-232 channel. Don't forget there's also the remote control of the Talent's input audio as well. This is a CAN, Control Area Network Interface, to expand the number of relays from 2 in and 2 out to 8 in and 8 out with the Tieline CAN 8+8 accessory box. This is the LAN port, which will enable IP audio as well as remote control and configuration using the Tieline Toolbox software kit. This is a USB port, which can also be connected to a computer for remote control. This is an RJ11 telephone connector for voice calls over analog telephone lines, and this is the RJ11 for the built-in POTS codec. In summary, Tieline iMix G3 is more than just a remote broadcast codec. It has mixing capability, configurable communications, send-return mix monitoring, live callers in the field, PA outputs for monitoring or a live show, programmable hotkeys, 6 different codec transports for delivering program or communications anywhere in the world, as well as a complete suite of remote control and a built-in digital matrix router. This replaces literally tens of thousands of dollars worth of equipment, plus countless hours of setup and configuring, all in a simple box. That's why we say it's like an entire remote truck in a box. iMix can be as simple or as complex as you want to make it. For a free demo of the iMix G3, simply click on the link next to this video and contact your nearest Tieline dealer. Tieline has offices in North America, Australia and Europe, so we can provide support to suit all time zones. Order your free Tieline iMix demo today and impress your management and your audience.